This is Marmots, and this is the first video of the series War Generator in Action. In Generator in Action, we will see how to handle every aspect of the development in order to be quick in the application development. So we are going to see how to handle binary fields. Okay. Here I have used a pattern that is having a document table and relationships with the entities that need to have documents. In the document table we have the file name or the name, identifying name of the document, the content type, the content, and the content length. Okay, you can also choose to have a binary field directly in a table. If you know that its content type, you can show the in the right place and the best way. So, but as I don't know how to show the documents and so on, I choose to take this pattern. So we have the applications generated, and we are going to see how is handled out of the box. We are using an application that communicates with the server via JSON. So it's pure JSON, and documents, document content binary fields are converted to base64. As it's a decision in application architecture, is an exception on how to handle those fields, I don't want you to make the decision. I don't want to make the decision for you. So by default, it handles in base64. And if you want to choose another way that it's not JSON, pure JSON, you can change it. By default, I don't want to make decisions, architectural decisions. So we enter, we go to documents, and we go to the form. We have to put the name. We have to put the content type, as we don't know it. We don't know which file to choose. You can enter this file, and you can add it, and this it, and it's inserted a file name, image, content length. We don't have, because we don't enter manually, but it's not required, so it's okay. And if we go here, we can open. By default, we download the file, so we get it here, the document we put. And there are some things to see. In list, we are not retrieving long fields. So here it's okay. Go to network, we find, and we see the preview, content. We have content length, content type, ID, name, and nothing more. Okay, but when we go to the detail, we are retrieving the content in base64. This is not always nice because it's so big to present in the first query. So one of the first thing we have to do is to tell that documents binary fields are ignored when getting, but are property when setting. This way we don't have the content in the query, but we have the content to set it. Okay. And we don't want to get the Base64, but we want to add a service that we have here. I use this methodology to add add-ons because I regenerate the application for any reason. These methods will not be overwritten. So it's a good practice to make this. What do we have here? We have two more services, two more endpoints in document. Upload to upload a document by the moment it's not needed, but view is needed because we don't want to get the Base64 in the detail. We want to have an href that to get directly the byte array. So once we have this, we can change this URL for the right one. So what we are going to do is to go to front end part, go to document. In the detail view, we have the content. We are showing it in Base64 with document content, and this is not nice. So, document content we are not getting anymore. So we can, if we add this, if we won't show nothing. So document ID, it will be always document ID, and document is required, so it's not necessary. Target new, it's okay. NG show document ID. And href, it is services document view and here is document ID ng href. This is the detail view. We have to put the same changes here. This is outside at all, and this is changed by the world. Also, in the form, we have this, so we'll change it, but excuse me. NG show document ID, NG href, nice, and that's it. And the same thing we have to change in the model form. This and it's okay. So if we go here, we are going here. We will open the ones we put. And when we click here, we can open using the URL. Here, also in view, and so on. As we are getting the content type, we are setting it in the upload, in the view, we can have any kind of document. So it's really faster because this doesn't contain anymore the content, but when you click, you get the file and without converting to Base64. So now it's okay. Another thing is to go to the form because we don't want to add those fields manually. Okay? So we have to go to the document, look for to do. This is a to do as done by is to do by me, but this is there are some to do's that are manual things that have to be done before generation after generation. So we have to assign write values and change application stream, and we have done all yet. Application octet stream is not used anymore. We are using the view service. So as in write values, document name, each new value file name, content type, each new value file type, and content length is new value file size. The reason is commented out is because I know the name of the content, but I don't know those names. I don't know which field have you choose to handle the name, the content type, and the content length. I don't know if you are going to use the document table pattern, so you have to do it manually. And here, as in write values, is the same. This is the for the model form. Okay, so we have changed this, and if we reset, refresh, and we choose a file, we can see that all fields are filled. We can add it, and we can view and open download. We have open download, but as we know that it's an image, we can change this link to see the image, to see the image tag. And this is almost all about binary fields. It only there's one thing, it's some kind of custom, but it's the way I do it. In here, if we go to hotels, there are rooms. We have HTML fields. Here we can enter HTML. And this is prepared to insert images inside. It's a component developed by me, but it can be used to insert images. So we have to do some changes also. The first thing is that we will use the upload feature of this service. For now, we only have used this one, but now we will use the upload. So we are going to come here and to open document service. The method upload for the document service. So we go here and in document service. After create, we will add the upload. Upload service will call services upload, method post, content type, XRF form URL code, and we'll take the param. It will broadcast the document add, so if a widget is listening to document, it can change using this listener, using this message. So we have put this thing, we have document service alone to blow up the file, and we are going to test it. We refresh and we will make a screenshot here and we will put here. So we have added a document, an image here. It's only allowed to pass the image. If you pass the document, it will put only the name. We can move this image here and we can float here, so it's okay. And we can add it also some white frame. We can save, and if we view and inspect, this is an image tag using the view service from before, and We are not fooling the request with the Base64 elements. We have removed and we are using this view service. And the only thing that remains to do is to change the services, the unit tests, sorry, in order to the done. We go to document. For example, here, if we go to document, and when we create an element, we are going to create here. We will have the content because we only in the server side we will use it, but when we create the JSON, we don't have it. So we will have to go to services and document service. Sorry, document service test. Document service test. Here, when we create a document, we will put this document created in the, with the factory. We will insert it, sending the content. But when we retrieve it, we won't have the content field. We can test it. First, I prefer to stop the server so less things are running at the same time. So if we run this create method, okay, so expected array was null, as we are not getting the content. So we have to remove it, and we can test now. And it works as expected. So every place that we are getting the document content from the service, we have to change. Here in the generate method, and so on, because it will be it never will have a value. Also, we will have to add for the document service add-ons, we will have to add the two unit tests, but it's not covered here because you know how to do it. So that's it. This is how to handle the binary fields. If you want to use my patterns and my design, if you don't, you can choose how to handle them. By default, pure JSON and only handling the binary field with Base64. So thank you for the attention and see in the next video.